Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy with another in the series. Well, this just arrived. What you're looking at is an 1878 Edison tinfoil demonstration phonograph. This is actually a museum quality copy, but this was the very first phonograph that Edison actually sold. And Edison actually built two of these and then sent one to an agent in Paris to have it duplicated in France for sale in Europe. This is called the Hardy phonograph, built by Hardy in Paris for Edison. So, genuine Edison tinfoil phonograph. It has a 2-inch mandrel. It's capable of recording approximately 60 words, depending on how quickly you crank it, about 20 to 30 seconds. And I've installed a sheet of plain Reynolds wrap aluminum foil. This is 1 mil thick, 1/1000th of an inch thick. And I've got my parameters set. This machine just got here. I spent all day today going to retrieve this machine, literally all day. Very, very interesting day, very rewarding. This is quite a machine. It's quite substantial, as you can see. It weighs about 25 pounds. It is accurate in every detail to the original. Museum quality reproduction. Excuse me. I had to sell my left kidney to buy this machine, but that's, of course, why you have two kidneys, so you can own two Edison phonographs. In any case, we're going to do our very first recording on an Edison tinfoil phonograph. Now, I'm recording on aluminum foil, so I have no idea exactly what this is going to sound like. And this is going to be my very first recording, so it's going to take me several hours at least to learn the parameters of recording on a tinfoil phonograph. But this is quite a day. It's going to be a real experience to play with this machine and make recordings on it. So I've got my foil installed, I have my stylus set, I have my distance set, the stylus is locked into position, and we're going to make our very first recording. And like probably everyone else who's ever recorded on an Edison cylinder phonograph, I'm going to record Mary Had a Little Lamb. So first I've got to grab a rubber tip to put on the witch's hat horn. This is a standard witch's hat horn for the wax cylinder phonograph. And I put a little rubber cap on the end of it just to be able to rest it on the mouthpiece. And I'm going to be eventually modifying this to use a speaking tube, so it will be much more efficient. And again, this is my very first recording, so I have absolutely no idea how this is going to come out. And I'm recording on plain standard Reynolds aluminum foil. As I said, it's 1 mil thick, exactly 1/1000th of an inch. So, without further ado, let's make our very first recording on an Edison tinfoil phonograph. Hello, hello, hello! Mary had a little lamb, its fleece was white as snow, and everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Ha, ha, ha! All right, so now we've made the recording. We can see the indentations in the aluminum foil. So we unlock the stylus, we pull it back from the mandrel, we rewind the mandrel to its starting point, and then we can play the recording we just made. Now the indentations are quite distinct. Whether the recording is going to be distinct is a whole different ballgame. As I said, this is my very first attempt of making a recording on a tinfoil phonograph. So it's going to be interesting to see how this came out. So we find our starting point. We have a little pointer right here on top of the diaphragm holder. We line it up, lock it into position. All right, here's our very first recording on an Edison 1878 tinfoil phonograph. Oh, Well, it recorded, so this is going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be a very, very interesting process learning how to use this machine. And of course, as I use it, I'll be able to make much better recordings. And of course, I'm recording on aluminum foil. And I'm going to be trying tin foil, copper foil, brass foil, and if I can find it, lead foil. So it's going to be quite a learning process, something I have never done before. Quite a machine, and quite a special day to be able to own such a remarkably simple yet historic cylinder phonograph, a genuine tin foil phonograph. So it's going to be, as I said, a quite a learning process, but I wanted to do a quick video so you could hear it for yourself. It's an absolutely beautiful machine, and it is accurate in every detail, and I'll be doing some detailed videos on the machine itself. But I just wanted to document my very first recording on an Edison tin foil phonograph, and these are going to get much, much better. This was my first attempt, so I have a lot to learn, but it's going to be a real labor of love to learn it. So I just wanted to do a quick video. Just an absolutely magnificent machine. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. But again, I just wanted to do a quick video on my very first recording on an Edison tin foil phonograph. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.